Friends, we want to welcome you to the 2020 New York Staff Band Christmas Concert. Thank you for joining us today as we offer up this beautiful music of the Christmas season. The next piece that the band is going to play comes to us from the pen of a British Salvationist composer, Paul Sharman. This piece is built around that well-known Christmas carol, "It Came Upon a Midnight Clear." And we know the words, "It came upon the midnight clear," that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's all-gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing. Let's listen now as the band plays "On Christmas Night" by Sharman. Thank you.
We're so glad you're here with us today, and we're also very excited that we have with us today Chris Martin, the principal trumpet of the New York Philharmonic. and he's going to present today What Child Is This?, written by Douglas Court.
Thank you.
Friends, before the band comes and plays the next piece for us today, I just want to remind you of something that I think we're all aware of. Our world has been so impacted by COVID-19 that the need around us is very great. The Salvation Army is there on the forefront, offering food, clothing, gifts for Christmas. And today, as a part of our concert, we want to offer you an opportunity to join with us and possibly considering a contribution to the Rescue Christmas effort. During the concert, there'll be some information about ways that you can come alongside of others. Please consider that today. A few moments ago, we featured a piece on Christmas Day by New York Staff Band alumni Kevin Norbury. And now as we move into the next piece, we feature a piece written by another alumnus of the band, Steve Bulla. This piece features the beloved carol, "Lo, How a Rose E'er Blooming." From a tender stem had sprung, of Jesse's lineage coming, as men of old have sung, it came a flower bright, amid the cold of winter, when half gone was the night. Listen now as we have this presentation of A Christmas Suite by Bulla.
Thank you.
In just a moment, we'll hear from Chris Martin once again. This time, he'll be featured on John Rutter's Candlelight Carol, arranged by Andrew Wainwright. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Christmas is a season of hope. Perhaps this year, more than many others, people are truly seeking hope for themselves. One writer has put it this way: hope is the pillow for weary heads, the heart's ease for weary hearts. Micah 7:7 tells us, "But as for me, I watch in hope for the Lord. I wait for God, my Savior. My God will hear me." The Webster's Dictionary defines hope in this way: desire accompanied by expectation of or belief in fulfillment. Hope is also defined as someone or something on which hopes are centered. There's a beautiful old hymn by Charles Wesley called "Come, Thou Long Expected Jesus." This hymn was written in 1744, and it reads, "Come, Thou Long Expected Jesus, born to set Thy people free. From our fears and sins release us. Let us find our rest in Thee. Israel's strength and consolation, hope of all the earth Thou art. Dear desire of every nation, joy of every longing heart." And the psalmist goes on to say in Psalm 62, verse 5, "Yes, my soul, find rest in God. My hope comes from Him." And for some today, there may be many earthly reasons to lose hope. COVID-19, bad reports from the doctor, family concerns, the economy, global unrest, and other seemingly hopeless situations. But we are not without hope. In Jesus Christ, we find that hope beyond hope. The psalmist writes in Psalm 10:17, "Lord, you know the hopes of the helpless. Surely you will hear their cries and comfort them." There's a song that is sung, "In Christ Alone." We embrace this song. "In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease, my comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand." It's a song of hope. And also that familiar Christmas carol, "O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark streets shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight." And as I've been walking through this week, thinking about this message, thinking about the theme of this concert, those words from that beautiful song, "O Holy Night," the thrill of hope, "A weary world rejoices." Oh, that we would have the thrill of hope for this day, for this Christmas season, for the promise of Christ. And in closing, for the devotional thought for today, I share with you Romans 15, verse 13. "May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit." God bless you. The next piece the band will now share with us is entitled "Hope" by Kevin Larson. This piece is based upon two songs, "As with Gladness" and "Cornerstone." The title of the piece comes from the words of that latter one: "My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness." Listen now to this beautiful piece about the hope that we all desire. Thank you.
Thank you.
once again, we just want to remind you there's an opportunity for you to provide hope to people in need this Christmas. The information on your screen shares how you can help us rescue Christmas for a family in need. Thanks for your consideration. The next arrangement that the band is going to play for you is a brand new arrangement by William Himes. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. And we express that to you today. On behalf of the New York Staff Band, Merry Christmas to all, and God bless you.
Well, we thank you for being with us today. No concert is complete in the Salvation Army at Christmas time without hearing Christmas Joy. So this is Christmas Joy by Eric Leitzen. Merry Christmas.
Thank you.